अस्मत् गुरुभ्यो नमः, अस्मत् सर्वगुरुभ्यो नमः, अस्मत् परमगुरुभ्यो नमः. ஆழ்வார் திருவடிகளே சரணம், எம்பெருமானார் திருவடிகளே சரணம், சீரன்று தோப்புல் திருவேங்கடமுடையான் திருவடிகளே சரணம். ஸ்ரீமான் வேங்கடநாதாரியம் கவிதார் கேகேசரி வேதாந்தாச்சாரிய ஹரிஹோமே சந்நிதத்தாம் சதா ஹிருதி. வந்தே பிருந்தாவனசரம் வல்லவீஜனவல்லபம் ஜயந்தி சம்பவம் தாம வைஜயந்தி விபூஷணம். பிரசங்காத் ஸ்வஸ்வபாவோக்தி கர்மணோ அகர்மதாஸ்ய ச பேதா ஞானஸ்ய மகாத்மியம் சதுர்தாத்யாய உச்சதே. பிறவாமை தந்திடத்தானே பிறக்கும் பெருமைகளும் துறவாக்கிரிசைகள் தூமதி தன்னா துலங்குகையும் இரவா உயிர் நன்னிலை கண்டிடும் உலகின் நிலையும் மறைவாழும் மாயவன் நேயனுக்கு அன்று அறிவித்தனே. வி ஆர் என்ஜாயிங் பகவத்கீதா ஸ்லோகாஸ் ஹியர் அண்ட் தேர். கரண்ட்லி தி கீதோபனிஷத் வி ஆர் லுக்கிங் அட் தி சாப்டர் 4. Particularly, we wanted to see the Avatara Ragasyam as revealed by Lord Krishna. In the last class, we looked at the sloka from Arjuna. Arjuna Vacha Aparam Bhavato Janma Param Janma Vivasvadaha Kadamedat Vijaniyam Tom Ado Proktavan Idi. 4-4 sloga. Arjuna was saying, you are born, a Krishna, you are born much later after Vivaswan, Suryan. How could I understand that in the beginning you have instructed this yogam to Surya? That is what you are saying. I don't connect that one. It seems to be contradiction. You are born now. Surya was created 28 Chaturyugams back. So that is a question he was asking. And what was the inner meaning of that? So what is the inner motive? What Arjuna is putting in this one, asking this question. He wanted Bhagavan to reveal from his own mouth, Thiruvai Malandu Aruluvadu. That's what they say, from his mouth. The Avatara Ragasyam. Bhagavan is completely flawless. He is full of auspicious qualities, Tirukalyana Gunas. He is the emperor of the entire worlds, all the universes. Whether you take Nitya Vibhuti or Leela Vibhuti, all of them. He is Satya Sangalpan. Whatever he wishes, he can finish that one. Nobody can stop that. Nothing can stop him. Satyakaman, that means whatever he wants, he can achieve that one. There is nothing he is lacking that he wants to attain that one as a new. That great personality of the Lord, that great Bhagavan, came to the Bhulogam just like a Devas and Manushas, we are all born through the karma. He also has come like what we have born here. So when the Bhagavan's birth is like this, he wants to get clearly the doubts has to be removed. So Arjuna is asking a very general question. But Krishna, a good teacher, understand from the tone of the question, the inner motive of the student, what he is asking, and they try to answer accordingly. So Bhagavan understood the deep doubts of the Arjuna and he wants to reveal the Avatara Ragasyam slowly one by one. So that is where he is trying to answer in the next 5 slogas. Arjuna's question invites Bhagavan to expose the concept of divine descension, divine coming down, Avataram. Why Bhagavan makes the Avataram? When Bhagavan makes the avataram, how he is different from all of us. So that is the avatar ragasyam part he is going to say. So Bhagavan starts with the first sloka. Sri Bhagavan uvacha bahuni me vedidhani janmani tavasa arjuna tanyaham veda sarvani natvam veta parandabha. One of the beautiful slogans. Sri Bhagavan uvacha bahuni me vyadidhani janmani tavasa arjuna tanyaham veda sarvani natvam veta parandabham. 4-5 sloga. Let's look at the first, the word by word meaning, and then look all the details. Bahuni janmani. Bahuni na many, janmani na births. Bahuni janmani, many births. Me vedidani, for me it has happened, for me it is past. Bahuni janmani me vedidani means many births for me have passed. Tava cha, and also for you it has happened like that. So bahuni me vedidani danma janmani tavas arjuna. Hey Arjuna, there are so many births have happened for me and so many births have happened for you too. Tani sarvani, all those janmas. Aham veda, I understand. Even now I understand. All the births, it has happened for you, it has happened for me, all of them, I understand. Tani sarvani, all those janmas, aham veda, I understand. Arjuna parandaba is calling Arjuna with the adjective parandaba. Parandaba means the one who kills the enemies. So the one who is like a terror for the enemies. Tvam na veta, you don't understand any of those janmas. You don't understand any of my previous janmas. You don't understand any of your own janmas. So that is what he says. The Supreme Lord Krishna was telling, you and I both had many, many births. But you have forgotten them, Arjuna, while I remember all of them. That is a simple meaning. Bhagavan is clearing the doubts of Arjuna when he was asking, so how it is possible you could have told to Surya when you are born now? So Bhagavan wants to capture all the avataram and the ragasyams and everything. This is the first sloka. So Bhagavan is saying, Arjuna, don't think that we are born only now. You have born many times. I also have born many times. Namalvar says, Ennindra yoniyumai pirandai imayor thalaivam. Bhagavan makes avataram in so many different forms and species. Krishna implies here, I have appeared right now as a son of Vasudeva and Devaki in Mathurapuri. Before that, I have manifested, I have appeared in many, many forms. Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Hamsa, Ashwatha, so many different rupams I have taken. And I have done so many upadesam to infinite number of people. This yoga I am telling you right now, I have told this earlier to the Vivaswan, the sun god. Don't think it is a miracle. Don't think it is impossible. Don't think it could not have happened. At the beginning of the Kalpa, I have instructed this to Surya when I had the rupam of Sriman Narayana. At that time, I have done that one. So, you may not be aware of my births and many of my avatarams. I have born so many times, whatever the time, whatever the place, whatever the reason, whatever the form, whatever the leelas I have performed, you will never know because you are not a Sarvajnan. Sarvajnan means knower of all. You are not a knower of all. So that is why you don't have the Purva Janma Smriti of your births or my avatarams. And that is why, Arjuna, you are posing that kind of a questions to me. For me, whatever happens, anywhere, past, present or future, and everything, I have the direct vision, Sarvajnan. I am the knower of everything. I know about all the jivas and their actions. Later, in the 7th chapter, 26th sloka, Krishna is going to tell, Vedaham samadidani vartamani cha sarjunascha arjuna bhavishyani cha bhudhani cha. So, hey Arjuna, the past, present, the future of all the living things, I know. So, that is what he is going to tell. Because we both had many janmas, don't think there is no difference between you and me. You cannot remember any of yours, but I remember mine and yours also. So, Bhagavan is very simply explaining to Arjuna, merely I am standing here in front of you in a manusha rubam, as a human form, don't equate me to the rest of the jivatmas. I'll give an analogy over here. There's a king in the country. He visits many places. Sometimes he may visit the jail, the prison, to go there and inquire everything is good, are they being serviced properly, to get the first-hand knowledge. So when someone seeing the king in the jail campus is standing there, should not mistake and conclude that he is a convict. The king is punished for his crime. That is why he is in the jail. So don't ever think like that. That is a wrong conclusion. We know that he is in the jail merely as an inspector. Similarly, Bhagavan sometime comes down as an avataram to the samsara mandalam, to this Leela Vibhuti, but he is never left out any of his great qualities, his power, his energy, none of them. The way we had it as a Sriman Narayana is carried over here also. So the king has got the power, whether he is sitting on the throne or he is standing on the jail over there. Similarly, Bhagavan has got all of them. So don't ever assume this is a sentence for the king. No, it is a supervision for him. Similarly, for Bhagavan also. So this sloka was spoken by Krishna first to refute. There are a lot of people who are fools. Foolish way of thinking, oh no, we doubt Krishna is not God. And we know that one, he is not God. So there are non-believers. They argue, Krishna was born just like you and me. He was born on the mother's womb. He ate food, he drank, he slept, and he played. All these things are just like manushya karyam. So he could not have been God. So that is where some people are saying. And to refute that one, Krishna has told the first sloka, I am different from all of you. Here we have to add our Acharya also. Many times the Bhagavad Bhakti is easy, Acharya Bhakti is very hard to get. People always think, oh, he is also like us. He is also having the leg and feet. His feet is also dirty and he is also hungry. All these things, we are equating Acharya to a normal human being. That is also wrong. We should think Acharya as the walking God. Okay. Here, Krishna is emphasizing the difference between Arjuna the Jivatma, and him, the Paramatma. Although he comes down with innumerable times, so many times he does the avataram, he remains all the time omniscient. That means he is the knower of all the things. Unlike the individual souls like you and me, Jivatma, our knowledge is finite. Bhagavan's knowledge is infinite. We have the jnana sankosham here, shrunk over here. Why? Because of our karma. Jivatma and Paramatma may have some similarities, but there's a mountains of difference between Jivatma and Paramatma. We saw many of those things in the Tattvatraya Chintana Adhigaram, Tattvam, Idam, Purushartham. So when we say that one, Tattvam, Achitte, Chitte, Isuran, that Swaroopa, Swabhavam, all these things, we looked at that one. So, Bhagavan and us, in a nutshell to tell at this point, Bhagavan is all-pervading. He is present, parandadan paraviyul needurum parandulan. Namalvar says, the reason why we picked this Avadara Ragasyam and Bhagavad Gita is to explain Namalvar's Pasuram. So, Bhagavan is all-pervading, but Jivatma pervades only the body it inhabits. So, wherever it resides, that's what it's do. Bhagavan is all-powerful. We don't even have a small power to do. Let us say, how do you get out of samsaram by yourself? You don't have that power. We had to do only on His grace. Bhagavan is a creator of the world and creator of the law of nature. We are all subject to that one. That is why Bhagavan is a karanam, we become the karyam. Karyam means our atma is always eternal, but the janmas we are getting, that one, that is how it becomes a karyam. We saw in the Sribhashyam. So, Bhagavan is the upholder of the entire creation. We are being upheld, we are being hold on, supports, controls, and owns. Bhagavan is all knower. We don't even have a complete knowledge even in one subject. See, these are all some of the differences between Bhagavan and us. So that is where, just to point out, Krishna was starting that one saying, we had many births, but don't ever equate I and you, both are the same. So, Krishna here called Arjuna as Parandaba. That's a word he has used. In different places, different names were used. But there is a meaning for that. This word is important. Parandaba means subduer of enemies, destroyer of enemies, paining, harassing the enemies. He implies, Krishna is implying here, hey Arjuna, you are a very brave, very gallant, very valiant warrior, and you have slayed many, many powerful enemies. Now, do not accept the defeat to a simple doubt like this one that has gone into your mind. I am giving you the knowledge. Use that knowledge as a sword and cut off all your doubts and become a wise person. That is the reason why, yes, we use the word parandaba. When we look here, there are words I've used very interesting. Bahuni, that means many. Vyadidani, past tense, have happened, that is one. Tavas Arjuna, for you also Arjuna, giving an example Arjuna himself. So, what Bhagavan is saying here, the birth and death are true. They are real. It is not maya. It is not illusion. It is not delusion. It is not in your head. Birth is real, but the whole life is perishable because we are attached to the achetana vastu that is going to fall off. Nashwaram grihya manancha Viddi maya manomayam. We saw in the Uddhava Gita. World is real, but nashwaram, it is not permanent. So, Bhagavan's avataram here, as he brought about Arjuna's birth and his birth and everything, is proved to be satyam. I've been born many, many times. That is the truth. It is not a fake. And now in the next four slokas, Krishna is going to explain about his trimeni, is a divine body, the nature of its body, and why I have come here, what I am trying to establish, what is the benefit I am going to get, what is the benefit you are going to get because of my avataram. All these things, next four slokas. These five slokas put together is called the Avatara Ragasyam, and we are going to be looking that one from the Prabhati viewpoint. Kavidharkige Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimade Venkatesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Srimade Nighamanta Mahadeshikaya Namaha.